Hi everyone and welcome back. It's Vicky here and today I'm going to create a lovely Mother's Day card. I am going to use the Best Mom stamp set by Altenew and I'm going to combine it with the matching dies. Now this stamp set has beautiful sentiments which are perfect for your Mother's Day cards. To color my images, I am going to use the Altenew alcohol markers. Now this is the set that it is available at the moment, which is set A, and that means that they will probably come up with even more colors later on. Now in this set there are 12 different colors, and as you can see they do match perfectly together. I'm going to show you later on all the colors as a swatch. Now I don't know if you can tell, they are of triangular shape so they don't roll on your desk, and they have two different nibs. One is a fine tip and the other one is a brass. Now this is the fine one, which is great, and I really love the fine tip against the chisel tip, which I never use. And the other one is the brass nib that you are used to work with if you have Copic markers. Now they are nice and juicy, and that brass nib is perfect. I really love it because it's so soft. The barrel is black, but there is a gray ring that helps you to distinguish which one of the tips is the fine one. I'm going to use the marker on this piece of white cardstock so that you can see the different colors that are available. So all these colors from light pink to dark red blend beautifully together. They really blend like a dream. Of course, it depends on the cardstock that you are using. You need to work on an alcohol friendly cardstock. Now, as you can see, you get three different shades of green that are perfect for coloring your leaves. The pinks and red shades are great for coloring flowers. And there are also the blues, four different colors, for very light blue all the way to darker one. Now this set retails for less than $50, which means that each marker is less than $4, and it's a great set. I definitely recommend it. You get a nice selection of colors to color all your flower arrangements, and since this is the set A, you can start by getting this set. It's not overwhelming because all the colors match together and you get nice shades, and as they come up with new sets, you can build up your collection of alcohol markers slowly. There is also the black one that I forgot to show you, and I'm going to start creating my card now. I am going to stamp this beautiful flower by Best Mom stamp set. I am using my Misty to make sure that I get a nice impression, and I'm going to stamp my flower with Memento Tuxedo Black ink, which is an alcohol friendly ink, which means that when I will be using my markers later on, it's not going to smudge or smear. I'm applying a nice coat, and I am going to press with my Misty, and you will see that I will not get a nice impression at first, which is a good thing that I used my Misty here. I'm going to stamp once more to get a nice impression, and then I will bring my markers to start coloring. For coloring my flowers, I will be using three shades, from light pink to red, and you can see which ones I'm using because you can see the number on the cups on screen right now. I'm going to use the lighter one to apply color all over my flowers, and then I use the middle one and the darker to do my shading. And you can see that I am moving back and forth with my markers just until I'm happy with how my flower looks. And I hope you can see how beautiful they blend together. You can just use two of those markers, and depending on which ones you use, you would get a different look. I am going to continue with the same three colors until I color all my flowers, and notice how I am working on small areas each time, so I don't go by coloring all the flower with my lighter color and then move on to the shading. I find that depending on the cardstock that you are working on, before you go ahead and start doing the shading, the first layer of color might dry, which means that it's going to make it super difficult for you to blend the colors. Just work in smaller areas, do the shading, and then move on. It's going to make your life so much easier. And once I finished coloring all my flowers, I moved on to color the leaves. I am using the three shades of green in the set. You cannot go wrong with that. There are only three shades of green in the set, which really makes your job easy when it comes to picking up the colors. And you can see that these three greens give you a beautiful shading for your leaves. Again, I am working with darker at the beginning of my leaf and lighter as I go to the tip of the leaves. First I apply the lighter color and then I use the middle and the darker one to do the shading. And I hope you can see how beautiful they blend. They are nice and juicy. I'm going to put on some music so you can see how I color some of the leaves, and then I will come back once my coloring is finished. Now I have done all my coloring and I am going to run my image through my C6 machine with a matching dye. This is going to cut out that beautiful flower and it's going to give me the opportunity to pop it out on my card to add some dimension. And now we can go on and create my top panel. For that I'm using this white cardstock, and I have already used the stitched dies by Simon Says Stamp to cut out a rectangle that has a beautiful stitching all around. And now I'm going to use these tonic circle dies and make sure that I align it correctly at the center of my panel. I am running it through my C6 machine and this is the panel that I got. And before I go ahead and start assembling my card, I am going to stamp the sentiment, and this is important to do it at this stage because I know that I will be adding a lot of bulk with foam tapes and things that pop out. So in order to have a good impression of the sentiment, I need to do it now on this panel, which is flat at the moment. I am using my VersaFine black ink pad to stamp the sentiment, which always gives a nice and vibrant impression. Just remember that it doesn't dry quickly, so you need to leave it a few seconds without touching the sentiment, otherwise you will make smudges. Now for the background, I want to add some sparkle, so I decided to use this paper, which has actually adhesive at the back. I am going with a silver one, and this is by Tim Holtz. And I hope you can see how beautiful it shines. I am going to use this paper to cover up my card base completely. And by the way, I have created a standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5. I'm going to peel off the backing. And you see that I am going to completely peel it off. But I am going to hold on to that backing. Don't throw it away. And then I am going to use my scissors to cut out the excess. Notice how careful I will be while I am cutting out the excess, and that's because I am planning to keep that excess. I am going to stick it back to the backing so I can use it another time. This way nothing goes to waste, and I know that these strips will be perfect to cut out sentiments for future cards. So I'm just going to place them there and store them with the rest of the packaging. Now I am going to add some foam tape at the back of my panel to add some dimension. And I'm going to stick my panel on top of my card base. Also notice how my white panel is slightly smaller than the standard card, which gives me a beautiful frame all around my card. I have gone ahead and added some foam squares at the back of my flower, and now that it's ready, I am going to tuck it in on top of my card as if it's coming from that window. And I love how simple that card looks, but at the same time it's so elegant. A perfect Mother's Day card. Now, to finish it off, I am going to use my Nuvo glitter drops, and this dries totally clear. It's not going to add any glitter or anything. I already have too much glitter on my card base. So all I am going to do is to add dots at the center of my flowers. Now, although this looks milky at the moment, it's going to dry completely clear. As always, you can find a full list of all the supplies that I used today down below in the description area, as well as on my blog. You will also find links to multiple shops for your convenience. So that was the card for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. Here are some close-up photos of the card that I made today. And if you need more inspiration on Mother's Day cards, here are two more videos that I made a while back. Thank you all for watching!